Well, Al, thank you very much. It's and thank you for giving me about 5 minutes. I'm not going to detain you long, but first of all, I want to say how pleased I am that you're having this conference. I know my friend Sylvester Reyes helped facilitate this, and there's a lot of good people who care deeply about our international border with Mexico and the variety of issues that we know are on the front page of the newspaper and burden the lives of literally millions of people because of the federal government's inability so far to deal with important issues like immigration reform. And you know, when I think about border issues, I think about the fact that we've spent so much time focusing on immigration that we have not dealt with the important infrastructure and the staffing we need to facilitate commerce with one of our biggest trading partners to the south. I have introduced legislation I call the Emergency Port of Entry Personnel and Infrastructure Act of 2009, which would add additional personnel, which would give them better equipment, would redirect $100 million from the stimulus bill for high volume ports of entry, because we know that our trade with Mexico creates jobs right here at home. NAFTA is not a dirty word in Texas. I assure you, it's a positive word, and because people understand that when you have goods that can be sold in Mexico, that helps create jobs in the United States. I would just be remiss if I did not tell you about my very serious concern with the violence that we see from the drug cartels in Mexico. I remember meeting in El Paso, of course, right across from Juarez, where far too many people have been killed as a result of this violence, with members of the DEA, FBI, other federal law enforcement officials, Customs and Border Protection. And they told me, we have, and I can't remember exactly what the timeline was, but he said, we only have a discrete amount of time in which to address this problem. And I said, well, how are you counting that? What's the ending point after which it may not be possible to deal with this again? And they said, well, what it represents is the end of the Calderon administration, because we have no idea who may be elected the next president of Mexico, whether they will have the kind of commitment that President Calderon has had to fight the cartels. And I saw a comment that Congressman Reyes made, I think yesterday or the day before, which I agree with completely, and that is, we have spent so much money and sacrificed so much American blood to help bring democracy to far-off regions of the world like Iraq and now Afghanistan, and yet if we don't do everything we can, and I'm not sure what all that is, and I would solicit your views and advice, but if we don't do everything we can within our power to help our friends and allies in the Calderon administration fight the scourge of cartels in Mexico, then we may end up finding ourselves with a tremendously deteriorating situation there, which I really don't even want to contemplate. So I think I just got off the phone talking to Senator Dianne Feinstein, who I serve with on the Judiciary Committee, and we're going to get some hearings in the U.S. Senate, and I'm sure there will be corresponding hearings in the House, on how do we deal with this. Obviously, the Merida initiative was a very important, significant contribution we made to assisting the Calderon administration, the federal government in Mexico, deal with this scourge of the cartels. But clearly, whatever we've done to this point is not enough. We need to do more. And we need to know exactly what that is, respecting, of course, the sovereignty of our friends and allies in Mexico. We don't want to do anything that would not be constructive, but what can we do to help them deal with this scourge right along our border? Of course, the concern is about spillover violence into the United States, but we've already seen American citizens lose their lives, both in Mexico and obviously most recently in Juarez, but we also have seen in Nuevo Laredo people kidnapped as they've gone across the border, and people lost their lives there, caught up in this violence in one way or the other. And it is a very real and urgent concern of mine, and I know of yours as well. Finally, let me just say to this outstanding panel on immigration reform, this is something that I am absolutely committed to working on. I happen to chair the immigration subcommittee, or excuse me, I'm the ranking Republican on the immigration subcommittee and the judiciary committee. Worked with Senator Kennedy when he was the chairman. We miss him a lot. He, of course, he had his fingerprints on every immigration bill for the last 40, maybe 45 years. But unfortunately, he's no longer with us. And now Senator Schumer, who chairs that committee, and I have committed to working together to try to find common ground to advance the immigration reform, hopefully in this Congress. We told the president it's going to take presidential leadership. You need to use some of his political capital to move this issue. But I know there are going to be areas we're going to disagree. There always are. But I submit to you there is far more common ground out there than areas of disagreement. And we need to work from that core consensus of the common ground and work out from there to try to find a way to address this broken system. I always say this does not, our current status quo does not help the young woman who's a victim of domestic violence, who feels like she can't call the law enforcement officials because she's worried about being deported. This doesn't help the worker, the immigrant worker, who works hard for his or her wages, who is denied payment for those wages because the employer knows that they have nowhere to turn for recourse. And we know that so much of the violence, so much of the criminality that does occur as a result of our broken immigration system occurs in the immigrant community, who suffers the most. And so I can't think of any of us that don't have an important stake in a solution to this problem. And Al, I know that you and of course this distinguished panel is working hard on this issue, and you have my commitment to do everything I can. Again, I don't agree 100% with my wife, nor she with me, but I love her dearly. I've been married 30 years. And I think people of goodwill trying to work together to find common ground can make some big improvements in the status quo. The status quo is simply unacceptable. Thank you for letting me cross over the great divide from the Senate to the House and share a few words with you. Thank you for all you're doing, Alan, and the chamber, and it's great to be with you. You can count on my commitment.